You're watching India Today's coverage of Modinomics 2.0. We are being joined by some of the most important ministers in the Modi Sarkar who are explaining how they intend to deal with their sectors now that Nirmala Sitharaman has laid out the broad roadmap for the economy. Joining us at this moment is Gajendra Singh Shekhawat, one of the most important ministers in the new Modi scheme of things. He's the man who's responsible for the Jal Shakti mission, a new integrated water ministry. A lot of talk in the budget, and we've seen in the Prime Minister's recent speeches as well, essentially saying that water is the new Swachhta Abhiyan. Sending pipe water into every home is the number one priority of this government over the next 5 years. Gajendra Singh Shekhawat can hopefully try and explain how prepared he is to go out and achieve that target. Mr. Shekhawat, welcome. There was a lot of talk in this budget about the need to take pipe water to all homes. This is a big challenge, a monumental challenge, given the high levels of water distress. Tell us, how do you intend to approach this challenge? What is the first thing that you intend to do? What's your roadmap?
See, the first thing which a government could do in this sector was integration of the ministry and bringing water subject under one roof, which was scattered in different ministries and dealt by different ministries in different heads. So after integration, to look the water subject holistically. The second, the guidance by Honorable Prime Minister is to take care of source sustainability as well as the discharge, the treatment or reuse of the discharge water which is being supplied by the pipes to the household. And as far as the is concerned, we are still making, but we are going to do it is on challenge mode. And whatsoever state will work more, will get more kitty, as we did the same in the during the Swachh Bharat mission. So we have spoken to all the states, all the stakeholders. We did a meeting where almost 24 ministers relating to drinking water supply from different states, they came, and almost each and every state was represented through its officers. And we have sensitized them that how, what is our approach and how we wish to take this program forward.
We saw during the summers in Chennai, water literally ran out. There was a massive crisis. It's now when the monsoons are in full flow that the government has the opportunity to conserve water for next summers, when again there'll be a problem, possibly an even bigger problem. So when it comes to farm ponds, wells, check dams, trenches, this is the time to build it. But you've just got a new ministry, you're barely settling in. What are your preparations in this monsoon season to conserve water for next year? You can build a pipe, that's possible, but unless there's water flowing through that pipe, it means very little.
See, the total precipitation in our country is almost 4000 BCM a year, and the water which we are able to harvest in the surface water sources as well as the groundwater reach, our replenishable groundwater what we get every year, is almost less than 20% of that. So looking towards the situation and looking towards the other good practices in other part of the world, especially Israel, if I may quote, Prime Minister has envisaged and he has guided us to keep a primary focus on water conservation. He himself, while talking to the people in the first Man Ki Baat Karyakram, he emphasized on water conservation, water harvesting, the groundwater recharge in a big manner. And simultaneously, we have launched a program, and we have sent almost 2,000 plus officers, joint secretary and above level officers, plus technical officers and hydrogeologists from our Central Water Commission and Central Groundwater Board as a team to the water stress blocks. Almost a water stress districts, almost 256 districts which have been identified as critically exploited and over exploited districts. So we have sent the teams to those districts, and they are taken it is in a mission mode. There will be this mission will be continuing till the end of September. And in the second phase, where the retreating monsoon comes in four states, that way there will be the second phase. So that they will go there, sensitize the district administration, the people, they'll try to create a public movement for recharge of water, afforestation, the rejuvenation of old traditional water bodies and all water related issues. So we can harvest more and more water in the traditional sources, as well as we can replenish our groundwater sources in aquifer in a big manner.
You mentioned, Minister,
we have
the
taken
example
a program
of Israel. That, the difference between India and Israel is that in Israel, water is a public resource. In India, water is a private resource. And therefore, in somebody's farms, there is no check on how much water is being drawn out of a tube well, which is why water levels keep depleting in the manner in which they do. Is there a larger plan which will be required at some point or the other to take water from being a private resource to say, hey, this is now reached a point where this is a public resource, it no longer is a private resource?
Yeah, very well point taken, Rahul. I do agree that it is, as far as the constitution is concerned, it's not only a public resource, but also is subject to be dealt by the states. So, but if it becomes a public movement, on the basis of the success of Swachh Bharat Abhiyan and many others, I can tell with confidence that if it becomes a public movement and a people's voice comes, that water is precious, let us save it, let us judiciously use it, and let us reuse it, then I think it can be done.
So you have no plan of changing the status of water from a private resource to a public resource?
That's a big question. I cannot answer this at this moment on this platform.
Okay. PN Vijay has a question for you.
Shekhawat ji, namaskar. Can you let me know, because today the statistic is that 90% of Indians don't get safe potable water. Now, Pradhan Mantri ji is saying by 2024, entire India will get proper piped water. Can you tell me three specific strategies that your ministry has for achieving this in the next 5 years? And what is the type of investment that you're planning to in each of these three strategies?
See, first of all, the data, I think it is a debatable issue which you have stated that 90% of the people are not getting potable water.
Safe water.
The data
safe
supplied
pipe
by
water.
By the state governments as far as the distribution. See, let me tell you, the data provided by the state governments as far as the drinking water is concerned, the water is accessible for almost 79% of the people in the country through the stand post or the public water supply schemes. As far as the water in their premises, tap water in the premises is concerned, the average is, it comes out around 18%. And
if a household gets water for 15 minutes in a day, like they get in Chennai, technically that household is also accessible, but the quantum of the water that's getting is so little that people stand in long queues to buy the water.
I do agree, Mr. Vijay, as I have stated in my first sentence, that it may be a debatable issue, but that access to the water is available or not, or the quality or the quantity, everything is a debatable issue. But still, we are committed to deliver 50 liters per capita per day water to each and every household. For that, we will have to take two-pronged approach. One is the water supply depending upon the local sources. And as I have said, we are going to ensure the sustainability of sources and through the point recharge, through the groundwater recharge, and simultaneously to take care of disposal of the water, finally reuse of the water. and the other where the groundwater is not available or not safe. Then the other measures will be taken, like the surface water transportation scheme, surface water pipe, multiple villages schemes. And we have requested the states to come up with their plans as soon as possible.
Which states have been most proactive? You come from Jodhpur yourself, which is in Rajasthan, and there's water problem in Jodhpur, Bikaner, Jaisalmer, and across large parts of Rajasthan. So which states do you think have responded most actively to what you are trying to do, Minister?
I have spoken to all the ministers. We called a meeting, a full day workshop with the water resources minister as well as the drinking water ministers and the secretaries and officers. I found everybody is on board, and they are very keen. And water is such subject that nobody wish to lose the opportunity. So I just don't wish to state anyone, but more specifically, Uttar Pradesh is the state where I had been day before. The chief minister's approach is very aggressive, and he said that we are completely with you, and we will be working on the top. And as he proudly says that as far as the Swachh Bharat mission is concerned, when he came on the chair, the situation was altogether different, and within a span of 2.5 years he has changed the narrative, and UP is among one of the top states in Swachh Bharat mission. So he is so confident and so keen that we will be delivering the same in the piped water schemes also.
Okay, I'm going to leave it over there. Gajendra Singh Shekhawat, thank you very much for joining us. You have a very, very tough challenge. You know, and everybody else can have favorites. They may like somebody, they may not like somebody. But the one thing I can say for certain is that in Gajendra Singh Shekhawat's success or failure lies the success and failure of every Indian. There is no water which is available in the manner that we need. And therefore, water conservation is truly one of the biggest challenges that India faces. It's good that the Modi Sarkar has made it as big a priority it has. Let's see what Gajendra Shekhawat is able to do. I'm going to leave it over there. We wish you all the very best. You've got 2,000 officers out on the ground. Let's see how much of an impact they're able to make in this monsoon season and then beyond. Gajendra Shekhawat, for joining us on India Today, thank you very much.
Thanks for watching the video. For more such news and updates, please like, share and subscribe to India Today. Also, check out our other great videos from our channel. We know you will love to.